Morning.
I actually agree with that last caller. I think the beginning of the economic side of the problem was when the supply side economics came out with the no oversight, no regulation sensibility under Reagan. I mean, that just allowed a lot of greed and corruption to grow, and it was unmonitored and was not stopped. I know there's a lot of bogeymen like the media and the government coming to get you and all those things that Darcy was talking about. The Supreme Court is now starting to represent the percentages of ethnicities in this country. It's not represented by a straight board of white middle-class men that have a certain viewpoint and a certain proclivity towards big business and preventing any type of oversight over the economy. So I think if conservatism is not dead, it's certainly being left out of the debate. It's being left behind because this country is moving on. I don't believe religious arrogance and that opinion that makes the poor the enemy and people that need to be cared for and people that need a social network, those are not the enemy of this country. The enemy of this country, I think, is ignorance and not knowing history, not understanding what works, and not being practical and not being moderate in solutions. So I think the people, the millionaires like Rush Limbaugh and Coulter, they make a lot of money. They have a profit motive for throwing these incendiary bombs into the conversation. But the vast majority of Americans want to see something get done. And I think we're very lucky to have Barack Obama in the White House. He is an intelligent man. There is a certain segment of society that just will never accept the fact that there's a black man in the White House.
Barbara, thanks for the call. And you referred to those who serve on the court, three women and eight men, including the two former justices, all part of the C-SPAN documentary tonight. You'll have a chance to hear from them in their own words as they give their perception of the job that they have on the U.S. Supreme Court, and also an inside look at some of their chambers and inside the chamber where oral arguments take place. That's all tonight on the Supreme Court, our documentary that airs at 9 o'clock Eastern Time, 6 for those of you in the West Coast. And Glenn Beck, quoted in the piece this morning in the New York Times, when Barack Obama wins this fall, there are going to be plenty of pundits out there ready to declare the conservative movement, it's just dead. Don't listen to those clowns. The movement is stronger than ever, says Glenn Beck. It's the conservatives. No, no, it's the people masquerading as conservatives, named Republican, that are the problem.